Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to make a Pong game and it should look like so, that you have two rackets and one ball and a net, and you are going to send each other and you are going to have scores for both sides. And we are going to use it. For this, we are going to start a Windows Forms application and name it what you will. And then you have two labels, one label for CPU and one label for player. And you are going to initiate zero from the beginning, the text. And then you have a label at the middle, and you are going to use in that location x is 353 and y is minus 2, and then you have a size, width is 9 and height is 689. And then you are going to use those in text. You are going to use that I or something like that. Okay. Then you are going to use view code and it opens this, and you must copy all those namespaces and classes, and in class form 1 heritage from form you are going to use the initialize component in form 1 constructor, and you are going to use a global variable bitmap btm for drawing, graphics g for bitmap graphics, graphics scg screen graphics, thread th to access individual items in multi items, rectangle bal, rectangle dot empty, rectangle cpu is rectangle dot empty, rectangle player is rectangle empty, and the bal speed is 7, the bal speed y is 7, the move speed is 7 for CPU. Player score 0, CPU score 0. Point bal move is point empty, move to is point empty, ball boolean drawing is true, and load form, e form 1 at load, you can double click on form 1 at it appear this one. We are going to use btm, bitmap equals bit is new btm, this dot width, this dot height, g is graphics dot from image btm, the area is prepared for drawing. SCG is this of create graphics. Bal equals new rectangle, this dot width divided by 2, this dot height divided by 2, 40, 40. It make a rectangle. And player has a rectangle. This width minus 50, this width, this height divided by 2, and it is size 30, 150. CPU rectangle is 5, width is 5, and the height is divided by 2, and it is 30, 150. Okay, Tiho new thread draw, the and Theodore's is background true and Theo.start instead of timer. Draw is a method and we use try exception, and while drawing g.clear color.white if move to.y greater than player.y plus 100, player.y increments with move speed. If move to y less than player.y plus 100, player.y decrements with move speed. For bal y greater than CPU Y plus 100, we increment CPU Y with move speed, and it is less than decrement with move speed. And then bal.x increments with bal speed. If move bal move.y greater than bal.y, then increment bal.y with bal speed y, and if it is less than decrement with bal speed y. If player.intersect width of bal speed multiplicated with minus 1, it changed the direction, and label player.text we are going to increment and use it to string. If player.score is greater than 10, you are going to show a message you win and environment exit. It's finishes the play. If CPU intersect with of bal speed again is multiple minus 1, change the direction, label cpu.text cpu score plus plus dot to string, and if cpu score is greater than 10, the message appear you lose and terminate the program. If bal y less than 20, bal move.y equals this.height. If it is bal y greater than this height minus 80, bal move.y is 0 from the button screen. If bal x less than minus 40, bal move x is this width divided by 2 for the left side of the screen, and if it is greater than this width, bal move x is this width divided by 2 for the right side of the screen. g.fillRectangle brushes.green player. If g.fillRectangle brushes blue, it is CPU. g.fillEllipse brushes red is bal, and we are going to draw, and then catch is empty, and we are going to have a private void form 1 underscore mouse move is move 2 equals e dot location. Okay, it's all, and I hope that you have paused the video and copied the source code. We run the program, control F5, and you are going to move. is only move the move your mouse. Okay, you win. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.